Hey everyone, this is Nick, and I wanted to come to you with a really cool photo editing trick that you can do right inside of PowerPoint. So this is a photo that I took from PowerPoint. It's one of their stock images, these beautiful blue and gold macaws. And this photo effect with kind of the left half of the photo all broken up, I learned this trick. I just saw it from Ram Gopal over at Presentation Process. I'll put his links down below in the show notes. Please go and subscribe to him. He gives the most amazing PowerPoint tips and tricks for great presentation design and all these little hacks behind the scenes hacks that you can do right inside of PowerPoint. You don't need fancy design software to do something really cool like this. I'm going to go ahead and escape out of this image. We're going to go into our slide deck here, and I'll show you how we can accomplish this. So remember, when you want to insert a photo, just go to the Insert tab, and then we click on the Picture tab right here, Stock Images. That's totally great. I already went in there. I searched for macaw, actually, and that's what it popped up with. I made it a nice full bleed image. That means the image is scaled to fit on the very background of the slide, so the entire, all of the edges are hitting the slide edges right there. Now, I'm going to go ahead, and what I'm going to do to make this photo effect is, first, I'm going to go up to the Transitions tab. Now, PowerPoint has tons of different transitions. I really don't recommend most of them if you're giving a presentation, because some of them can be really distracting and kind of gaudy, but you can use them in some of these fun ways that Ram Gopal has given us over there on his Presentation Process YouTube channel. So one of the transitions that I'm going to use, I'm going to go all the way down here. I'm going to click on down, and I'm going to go to this vortex transition here. Now, when you click on it, it's going to give you a preview of what it looks like. And you can see it kind of gives that broken up effect and just swirls around sort of the tornado. If you wanted to change the effect options, you could click on this drop down menu, and we could go from the top. It'll show us what it will look like from the top and from the right. Let's look at what it looks like from the right. Super cool. And from the bottom. I think I'm going to stick with from the left, because I really liked that sort of effect here. So I'm going to go back to from the left. The other thing you want to pay attention to is over here under the timing button. Right now it's defaulted to 4 seconds. So that just means it takes 4 seconds for that transition to fully happen from start to finish. I'm actually going to increase this, and we're going to increase it to 10. So it's pretty slow. So we're going to increase it to 10 seconds. And then the other thing I want to do is it's already clicked on after. If for some reason yours is clicked on mouse click, just uncheck that and select after. That just means that when we put it into slideshow mode, it's going to automatically happen. All right, so now what we're going to do is first look on your keyboard and find the print screen key. Once you see that screen, I think you know where I'm going with this. So make sure that your finger is sort of close to that print screen button on the keyboard. We're going to put this into slideshow mode. And as soon as it gets to the point in the transition that I want to take a photo of it, I'm going to click on print screen. So let's go put it in slideshow mode. My finger is on print screen. It's going to go pretty slow here. And now we start to see the transition. And let's see, I like this one right there. Perfect. So I pushed print screen, and now I'm going to click out of this. Now this was that was my second slide that I had made before, but I have inserted a new slide right here. And now since you push print screen, that means that whatever's on your screen, it takes an immediate copy of it. I'm going to right click, and we're going to push paste as picture. And you can see here that it's actually taking a screenshot of both of my screens, both of my monitors. I have two monitors here. So I'm going to go up to the picture format menu, crop the photo. We're going to crop it right here. I'm going to click on this. Now this is a beautiful photo here. Now what I'm going to do, I've made many other videos about the bright slide, free bright slide PowerPoint add-in right here. In this first on the picture format, I'm actually just going to click on compress pictures. That gets rid of all of the extra space that I cropped out of the photo. So click OK. I'm going to go back up to my bright slide add-in and click on match to size, and it's going to match this photo to the size of my slide background. I'll go and click crop, and now I have this really awesome photo effect here in PowerPoint. It is so cool. I hope you go ahead and give it a try. What an awesome trick from Ram Gopal over at Presentation Process. Again, I'm going to put his info in the bottom in my show notes, and you can go ahead and give him a subscribe too. If you like this video, I hope that you will subscribe to my channel. Also, hit the button and hit the bell next to it to get notified every time I post a new tip in data design, Excel, PowerPoint, or Word. Remember, you don't need to be a professional designer to look like one using the software that you already use every single day. I hope you all have a great day, and I will see you next time.